12 days of Advent. So now, today, we are going to talk about the top six series. So at number five, or number six, I should say, of the top, or the top six, the six anime series that I need to start in 2018. So, like, you know, pretty much looking, no series that I've already finished and that I want to start next year. Pretty much that's what today's video is about. So start coming in. At number six, we have ReZero and Yuri on Ice. The reason I both these shows at number five is because both of these were very popular animes in 2016. One I can see was, the other one I don't understand other than the Furro Found Girls losing their shit. Ugh. But anyway, so I want to watch ReZero mostly due to the fact that it interests me enough to where, like, I know fuck all about ReZero other than Rem's Confession because of Crunchyroll Anime Awards. I love Amelia memes, because I see it everywhere, and it has a plot about time travel. That's it. That's all I know. It looks interesting from what I've seen of ReZero, so I'm going to give it a shot to see how it is. And Yuri and I just see if that show's any good, like, at all. Now, there hasn't been a word on a dub for ReZero. I've looked up, and I haven't seen anything. Funimation hasn't announced anything for Crunchyroll, nobody. So, I'm going to have to watch up. You're nice. I am watching the dub because, goddamn, that show's not worthy of the extra effort it would take me to read subtitles. So, that is why they are both number six on the list. Or number six. Number five goes to the Berserk Golden Age arc OVAs, the three movie trilogy. Mostly due to the fact, hear me over. I'm not going to say, like, I love Berserk. Hi, horses. Like, I'm not going to, like, I fucking hate Berserk, which I think Berserk is pretty good. Keep my eyes. I have not read the manga of Berserk. Like, at all. I've seen pictures of it. The art looks fucking phenomenal. I hear people doing it. It's like Tokyo Ghoul, where I was like, tell you, like, you know, read the manga. The anime is complete and utter trash. You know, with Berserk, I can kind of see that. Mostly due to 2016. But Tokyo Ghoul, I do not get that. I'll talk about Tokyo Ghoul in day 7. That's going to be day 7 when I'm going to talk about the TG manga. So, Berserk 2016, when I saw that anime, it was what definitely in the first series I saw when I was, like, you know, first got into anime and I was starting to get into, you know, seasonal anime. I had Crunchyroll. I didn't get a subscription to it. I still don't have a subscription to Crunchyroll. I just watch shows with ads. I got no beef with that. I got no problem with that. but I saw that show along with a bunch of other series, you know, Mob Psycho. I think this was summer of 2016 this year, because there was Mob Psycho, New Game, 91 Days, and Berserk 2016 were like the four shows I watched, as well as Ace Attorney, which that show also bored me to death. And Berserk 2016 just bored me to death. Like, I didn't care about the characters, like, at all. Maybe it was because I wasn't paying attention much, and this was, like, when I was just starting to get into season, like, and I had to read the subtitles. If I watched it nowadays, I probably could get a lot more interested into it, because this was when I started when the second season dropped. I actually gave a shit about the characters in that series. You're in the animation, yes, I know, it looks odd, but, I mean, it's not like I can't look at it, but it's like, it's CG. It's CG, I'm like, whatever. The music, but in both these shows, the music and the voice were really good. If I actually ended up dropping Berserk 2016, I was like, I'm done with the show, this show is boring me to death, I'll wait till all the anime, I'll wait till all the episodes are out, just marathon through, which is what I did. And so, yeah. Berserk 2016 bored me half to the second season, but much better. I would like to see Berserk return for a third season. I don't know if it will. Don't know if it won't. I don't know. I don't want to see the Golden Age arc movie just to see the Golden Age arc, because like the only arc Berserk had not seen. And just to see how far they go in the OVAs, what happens in, like, when the eclipse happens. Like, I have not read the manga, but I know what goes down in the Golden Age arc when that eclipse hits. Give away spoilers for any of you guys who've never read and watched Berserk. Besides, so yeah, that's why number five, and Netflix has had all three of the movies dubbed and sub. I'm gonna be watching these dubbed. And so yeah, that is why Berserk, the Berserk 3 OVAs are on number five on the list. I'm not gonna talk about the 90s yet because the 90s anime isn't anywhere to watch legally, and I'm pretty sure the DVDs are out of print. So, number four, goes to Cabinary, and number four on my list is Cabinary and the Iron Fort. Another popular anime that aired in 2016. I want to watch it mostly because Funimation just released the Blu-rays, and the Blu-rays are coming out very, very soon. I'll be picking up the Blu-rays. We're watching on their Funimation now. They have some with the dub. We're watching it dubbed, of course, because why watch a sub when I can watch it dubbed? That's me with the comes to anime. If the dub is available, I'll watch it there, because if I have the dub, what's the point of reading the subtitles? I only read the anime subbed if there's no dub available, or I just don't feel like watching the dub, or because it's either locked behind, like, say, you go and get it via the Blu-rays, I don't want to pirate. That's like the only reason why I solely watch the series subbed is after it finishes airing, is just because either there's no dub available, or it's locked behind something else. So yeah, and so Cabinet and the Iron Fort, and it was also done by the studio Witsu, which was also the same studio that did Attack on Titan. Loved Attack on Titan. I believe the series that's beginning season 2 this year, like spring. That's why Attack on Titan season 3 is coming out in summer of 2017, or 2018, I should say. And yeah, the art style looks really good, and it just looked really good. And I believe, now also like ReZero, I know fuck all about the series other than it's like a post-apocalyptic series like Attack on Titan, but just replaced Titan with, I want to say, zombies? It was either zombies or vampires on like a train, with like the steampunk, like, you know, design and aesthetic. Yeah, that's why it's Cabinet and the Iron Fortress is number 4 on my list. Now, number 3 on my list goes to Konosuba and Blood Blockade Battlefront. Now, and I guess you could also say Trigun. Now, Konosuba is a show that I've always known about recently, because, you know, it's a comedy show. I see, you know, I see memes of it all the time, of, you know, purification, purification, purification. You know, I see it all the time. The art still looks really great, and actually, it's actually one of the few shows my brother actually watched. And keep in mind, my brother is like the definition of a casual anime. Like, the dude maybe watches like one new series a year. Like he's so casual, he won't even admit that he likes anime. He'll admit that he likes particular, see, like, you know, Death Note, Tokyo Ghoul, SAO, Berserk. But he will not admit that he watches anime. Because, you know, well, the connotations, well, you know, with all these adventures and shit. But yeah, and actually my brother's also seen Your Name 4 times. And which I was like, 4 times Your Name? They must be good. Which is another anime I would like to watch this year. The Blu-ray just came out. So I'll be watching that, so you can put that as an honorable mention. Anyway. But yeah, Konosuba, I love my comedy series, I'm definitely for it. There's been no word of a dub, like, at all. The show's been out for, like, season 1 came out, like, what, 2016 was it? And season 2 just came out, like the beginning of this year. There's been no word of a dub. I don't know, Funimation hasn't announced anything, Crunchyroll hasn't announced anything, Sentai, Aniplex, nobody's announced anything of a dub. So yeah, I'll be watching it subbed. But yeah, I mean, I've got no problem watching the show subbed, I'm just saying. There's no word of a dub at this current moment. So yeah, that is, and also Blood Blockade Battlefront, because it's done by Studio Bones. And you guys know, Studio Bones, I consider them the GOAT. And so yeah, the season 2 is airing right now. I've been meaning to get started on the series this year, but I have been just so caught up, of course, with the 12 Days of Anime. I got my fucking midterms coming up this week. I've been trying to know also, you know, other shit, and get caught up on the seasonal shit, because I have been slacking on seasonal anime. I have been slacking on seasonal anime. So yeah, and also I believe Blood Blockade Battlefront is done by the same manga that did Trigun, which I've also been watching Trigun. I'm kind of like, you know, turned out, kind of like, you know, put it on hold for the moment because I'm busy getting other series. But I've seen about like 7 episodes of Trigun dubbed. Really love Trigun. I love that series. Definitely a great series. I love Trigun from what I've seen in it. So yeah, that's why now. So that's why both the shows. Number 3 on my list. Now, number 2 goes to Twin Starred Exorcist. Now, Twin Starred Exorcist is another series I know next to, I know fuck all about, other than it looks like, other from the trailers I've seen, it looks like a shonen series that's like Blue Exorcist in a way, kind of like, you know, Exorcist taking out demons, but I think it's not going to be as much like, it's not like Blue Exorcist, but I love my shonen anime. Twin Starred Exorcist looks pretty good. Now, if I remember correctly, the show has been confirmed to get a dub, along with, like, you know, Crunchyroll announced they were going to do dubs for, like, Gintama and Berserk 2016. They announced Iron Twin Sword or Exorcist, if I remember, but on there, but as well as, I think, Cabinet and the Iron Fortress. But there's been no word of, like, there's not been a cast announced, nothing, like, a release, nothing for Twin Sword Exorcist. So that's kind of weird because I could have sworn I heard the show got confirmed for a dub, but yet there's been literally nothing about it. So yeah, that is why Twin Star Exorcist is number two on the list. And now number one goes to, of course, Naruto Shippuden. Or is it Shippuden? How is it pronounced? Is it pronounced Naruto Shippuden or Shippuden? Write down in the comments, type one if it's Shippuden, two if it's Shippuden. Like, cause I'm like, I've heard people pronounce it both ways. I've heard people pronounce it Shippuden, heard other people pronounce it Shippuden. I love Naruto. You guys know how much I love Naruto. My fourth favorite anime of all time. And man, I cannot wait to get started on Shippuden. And like, I'm trying to get through a bunch of other series first before I get to it, cause Shippuden is 500 fucking episodes. Now, in case you're wondering, I will be watching it dubbed because I prefer the dub. And for shonen and for like long running shonen anime like Naruto, I prefer to watch it dubbed just so I can just sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. Instead of, you know, keep my eyes on the bottom of the screen reading the subtitles. So yeah, you guys know how much I fucking love Naruto. And I can't wait to see Naruto versus Sasuke Part 2, Kakashi versus Obito, Madara, the fourth great ninja war. Like, I can't wait to see all this shit dubbed. Like, you guys know, and seeing Kakashi when he was with Anbu, that's gonna be a hype to see whenever I get to that part in Shippuden, the dub of Shippuden. As well as, you know, now I have seen my fair share of clips of Shippuden. I've seen, you know, I've watched and rewatched the Kakashi versus Obito fight, dubbed and subbed so many times. I love that fight. The music, the voice acting, from the dub and the Japanese was different. I mean, the art animation. This is why I say, like, this is why I love Studio Paramount. When they put their hearts into something, they can make something great. Which is why I'm always like, you know, Chibi, when Chibi is always constantly, you know, shitting on Studio Paramount because they dared ruin their precious little Tokyo Ghoul, even though it's the reason they got popular in the first place. But anyway, like, Tokyo Ghoul, sure, yes, they did, you know, kind of just, you know, say fuck it to the manga, but when you look, but they're still much better than Toei. I mean, left and straight, they're nowhere near as bad as Toei. I mean, there's a reason that the Namek blows up in 12 episodes is a meme thing. As well as, and I mean, do we need to mention the art animation super and the pacing of One Piece? Like, Studio Paramount, no, sure, you're like, oh, but what? Studio Paramount did filler for Naruto Shippuden for 2 years! Well, yeah, but some of it was canon, like, they were adapting the books, like the Itachi book. So it kind of makes sense. But at the same time, 2 years of filler, after the manga was already over, it's pushing it! But I've always enjoyed Naruto filler. The filler that was in the original Naruto series around the end was just like, you know, an anthology of like, you know, episodic, you know, missions that the crew was going on with Naruto. I love that. Because we got more of Hinata, which she was barely in the series. We got more of Hinata, Shikamaru, the rest of the crew. It was just great. I just love the dope. I love the filler for Naruto. I'm not one of the guys like, ugh, filler. It is absolute garbage. How dare you put it in my head? I'm like, I can enjoy filler. Like Black Clover. Like, from the three episodes I've watched, in those three episodes, a majority of that is filler. The second episode was completely filler. But I still really enjoyed it. I love seeing, you know, more of the backstory of, you know, Asuka and Yuno as kids. I like that. Like, a lot of people were like, you know, no, there shouldn't be this much filler. Now, sure, three episodes on one chapter, come on now! But I'm not that, but I got no problem with that because I'm really enjoying Black Clover. Honestly, I like from three episodes of Black Clover I've seen compared to the 50 episodes of One Piece I've seen, I honestly like Black Clover a lot more. Which, by the way, One Piece is another show I would like to make the start of this year. Like, after I either get caught up to the dub when Naruto shipped it, or when the dub finishes, I'll begin work on One Piece. Get back to work on One Piece. And also say goodbye to the world, because, Lord help me, I have so much of One Piece to get through. Like the dub's like 500 episodes in. Oh man, that's gonna take a while to get through. But yeah, guys. Naruto Shippuden, that's my number one because I fucking love Naruto. Can't wait to see more Greninja, more Madara. Naruto vs. Sasuke, dub. That's just gonna be hot. That's gonna be hot. That's gonna be lit. I cannot wait to see the Pain Arc. That's just gonna be hot. So yeah, guys, that is why Naruto Shippuden is number one on my list. So hope you guys enjoyed the video. Leave a like if you did, subscribe if you follow my screen, screen if you like, links in the description box below. And as always, come back for more. See you guys next time.